Yep.
And I don't think that's justified by any means whatsoever.
Yep. And they're pretty upset about it. As you watch the reaction and the marks now coming up, they're
This is the mark for artistic impression, and again, this is wrong, I think. And of course, that's the way the judges on across the board consider it.
Really a matter of controversy after the short program of the pairs skating. However, we know that the Carruthers, for example, got marks which seemed lower than they should have deserved, but we don't know the final result, the standings. Al, do you have the standings yet?
Yes, we do, Jim, and here they are. As expected, Volova and Vasiliev did very well. They're on top. Now, the Carruthers are tied for second with the other Soviet pair, Selezhneva and Makarov, and the co-favorites to win the gold medal, Bass and Tierbach of East Germany, are currently in fourth place, and as you know, Jim, this accounts for 29% of the overall score.
Well, now, Dick, we've seen this sort of thing happen before, but I think it would be interesting if you'd explain to the people exactly how that happened.
Well, I think that what happened was that the judges gave generally low marks to the Carruthers. What I didn't stop to realize when I was saying that those marks seemed rather low was to figure out how they related to the marks that those judges gave to the other skaters. And that's the thing that we kind of always forget. The end result was that the Carruthers are in second place, tied for second place, and I think that's right. Sometimes the audience gets a little upset when the judge doesn't give their favorite skater a perfect mark of six, and they boo them. What they must remember is, where did that judge put their favorite skater in relation to other skaters?
Well, we see that now on the screen.
And here it's all right. I think one of the things that is a little bit maybe off here is the fact that the Canadian judge had the Carruthers in fifth place, which I think was relatively out of line. But again, that's the way it was.
So, Jim, we're looking forward to Sunday night when 70% of the overall score will be accounted for. And some surprises today. I think we're going to have a most interesting conclusion to this event.
One of the more complicated subjects in sports is judging and figure skating. Later tonight, incidentally, there will be a special edition of ABC's Nightline concerning the death of Soviet leader Yuri Andropov and its implications for the future. That will immediately follow your local news, which means that our continuing late-night coverage of the Olympics will be following Nightline this evening. Looking forward to tomorrow, do we have a show for you? We have, in fact, three shows for you. The first one beginning at 11 o'clock in the morning, Eastern Time, and going to 1:30 in the afternoon. We'll be back again from 3 to 5 in the afternoon, and then our big three-hour show at night, which will be from 8 to 11 Eastern Standard Time. Let's take a little more specific look forward to tomorrow's events. Here we go. The date, of course, February 11th, first Saturday. There'll be plenty of hockey live on the morning show. We'll have the United States against Norway. And then tomorrow night, we'll have Canada against Finland, the critical game not only for them, but for the United States. The two-man bobsled competition reaches its final day. The final two runs on Mount Trebevich. Yes, we have women's downhill training. The women's downhill event has been canceled for tomorrow to give them more training because they haven't trained for several days. The interesting thing to see how the favorites do. More of luge, the third of 4 days in the singles competition. All of us getting to know that sport a little bit better all the time. Our first look in these Olympics at biathlon, a very unusual sport which is a combination of cross-country skiing and shooting. Ski jumping, yes, the 70-meter ski jump of the Nordic combined event. Usually, they're Norwegian or Scandinavian specialty. This time, an American's one of the favorites. His name is Kerry Lynch. And then ice dancing. Jane Torvald and Kristen Bedeen, in the compulsory phase of their event, got three perfect marks of six. They're terrific. All that tomorrow. We'll see you.